my key. Shit.
It's all good. I figured, I'm like, eh, I don't see you saying it's super close. Okay.
Yeah, we run my key so often.
We do. We love your key. Ran mine earlier, but yeah, that one didn't go so hot, eh?
No.
It happens.
It's what it is.
Continues to dominate the field.
Yeah. Oh, it's an augmentation of Ogre.
Oh, fuck. What does that do? Is this he just buffing the Warlock?
Yeah, he buffs the group's overall damage. He ain't going to do shit.
Okay. Okay. Weird. I've never done a key with one. I don't know what to think.
Yeah. Well, it just got released on Tuesday.
Watch out, buddy. Watch out, buddy. Well, hey, you know. Give it hell, I guess. I have no idea what to expect. Hey, let's go. I mean, with the Warlock doing 500k, I think we're okay.
Yeah. Like... Well, and so what they do, they buff, it's weird. So they buff the rest of the group to do more damage. Like, one of their major cooldowns is for like 11 seconds, they pull all of the damage that the group does, basically, and then replicate it on whatever mob.
I see.
So yeah, it's a weird spec. It seems interesting, and I'm now curious to see how it plays out.
So does that mean I should, does that mean I should go, well, I don't know. I mean, maybe I should have gone DPS trinkets, I didn't think, you know, but yeah.
I have no idea, to be honest.
I don't either, but I just figured, I guess he's buffing everybody, or just the world?
I don't know how augmentation works.
I haven't even looked into it, I haven't fucking, I know it's a support class, I don't know.
My mage and I are fucking warlock and doing over 200k each. I'm happy as hell with that.
You ain't
I don't
lying.
Care.
I saw 700k from the warlock and GG's, you know? Let's go. Interesting. I just saw him like crush those. Cool.
Yeah, augmentation, one thing that I know is great about Evoker in general,
I
have a lot of control.
Yeah, and like, dude, as someone who, like, I'm all about mechanics and, like, group contribution and fucking crowd control and everything else, I'm like, man, I might alt that. I might, because I have an Evoker, you know, I'm like, hey.
Yeah.
I might do that. I might fuck around with it.
Augmentation would be fun, dude. And it'd be nice to have someone that knows how to play the damn stuff.
You ain't lying. Plus, I do tons of coaching, and like, hey, I've already coached so many Devastation Evokers. You know, like, if I know that one, I can teach augmentation. That's awesome. That excites.
Yeah, me as well. How did you get into coaching, by the way?
I mean, first off, I was a raid leader for 5-6 years, you know, like, training players up, and I was on a small server chart. So basically, it started with, it was so hard. We were one of the top rating servers on Blood Scout, Maeve, Dune Maul, Stone Maul. And it was really hard. We'd always clear Heroic, and then we'd do a couple of bosses on Mythic. But man, we'd lose our best players eventually because we couldn't progress because we couldn't fill the group. You know, it's back when you had to have 20. So we'd have, say, 12 to 15 really good players. Like, really good players. And then a few that I'd have to recruit and train and train and train, and that's when I got really good at coaching, because I'd have to find players that were nowhere near ready for Mythic rating and train them to Mythic rate, you know. And after that I kind of just, it burned me out, you know. After a while, I'm like, all right, I'm gonna get into Mythic Plus, like, this is new for me. Honestly, the thing that really made me want to do it is you know, my relationship ended at the time, 6-year relationship, and I was in keys. I was a Fury Warrior at the time. I had this blood DK tank. And this guy, to say the least, was the worst human being I've ever met. The absolute worst, you know? The kind of guy that, like, he's in Discord with us, and we're trying to do, like a 12, you know? Getting our asses handed to us. He's showboating, living through everything, not coaching at all, just picking at us and making fun of us and whatever. And we're just like, okay, you know, like, we're trying to, like, me and my buddies are just trying to learn, you know? I remember thinking, right, there's got to be a better way than this. This is horrible. You know, like, I'm going to start tanking, because before I just tank raids and normal heroic dungeons, whatever, the regular stuff. And I'm like, hey, I'm going to throw myself into Mythic Plus and see what I can do. I gotcha. As far as tanking Mythic Plus, and that's what I did. Went it from 1,200 IO to 2,200 IO to 3.3K to 4.6K. So, self-taught all the way. And ever since, it's just been my bread and butter, you know? And I just, I appreciate the struggle that players go through. I mean, no shit, like, pugging keys and being called trash and they make a mistake and point the finger at you and bubble hearth, you know, like, dude, nothing worse. Yep. Like, and toxicity.
Bubble hearth, like the one paladin that we had, holy
I mean,
shit.
That is the absolute worst, you know, like that feeling of, man, I was, you know, if he didn't know, he made a mistake, why are you ripped? Why not tell him the right way? Hey, man, did you know that? Oh, thank you, he just learned. I mean, he may not be a nice person. He may rip you and, you know, the toxicity spreads and continues, but he tried. He tried to stop the cycle, and that's what's important to me. And ever since, man, I did thousands and thousands and thousands of carries through BFA, through Shadowlands. And these days, I actually have a good following, whether I'm pushing or doing viewer keys. I do less viewer keys. But I've kind of, I feel like I've just kind of earned that over time in building my following, that now people show up because they enjoy my company and enjoy my style. And, you know, that feels good. So.
Yeah, it's a good thing. I can say, I mean, that's certainly why, like, I wanted to get into push keys with you and stuff as well. It's just, like, it's more chill sitting here doing keys rather than constantly being stressed out about who's going to make a comment.
Oh, 100%. You're like, oh, they died. Oh, is he going to call them out? And they're shit-talking. All right, well, that's key. Nope, they're not even doing DPS anymore. He just stood in something because he wants to type back instead of freaking moving his character out of the way. You know, it's like, all right, yep, there it goes. People just need to freaking stop typing in chat. Don't get me wrong, there's a time and a place to direct your group, 100%. But that's why I posted this, that, and the other before the key started, so everybody's real clear on things, you know?
Right, you post a route before the key, so you don't have to be talking
Say,
about
hey, got any questions,
obvious.
Anything, feel free. This is the time. If you hate the route, tell me, you know? Come on, let's talk about it. I'm flexible, let's just talk about it. Don't halfway through be like, this route sucked. Be like, dude, I gave you 10 minutes to look over that route. 10 minutes, and now you hate it. You know, like, come on, man.
Yep.
But it happens, you know?
Yeah, I don't understand people. Like, they just, a lot of people just want to complain for the sake of complaining.
100%.
Things didn't go their way. Right?
And see, I worked in hospitality for 11 years, which is a lot where I kind of get my demeanor, right, is waiting tables, bartending, every customer's always right, very patient, whatever. And there are some people that go into a restaurant, no matter what, they show up ready to hate their experience. They are there because they know that you are good at your job and that you're not going to give them any shit. You're going to take it on the chin over and over and over. And no kidding, there's just those people like, oh, he's here. Okay, prepare to have the steak sent back, even if it's cooked perfectly. You know, I just let the chef know, not on you, bro. You know, it's coming back. And lo and behold, he eats 2/3 of it, bitch and moans, gets it refunded, you know, and it's like, all right, send him on his way. Don't make a scene.
That's another one of those where it's like, how did you eat 2/3 of it and then find out?
Believe me, I know. But it's known. It's like, at a certain point, though, depending on the food and beverage director, like, when I got stepped up to restaurant manager, it's funny, when I was working at the Hilton, this one guy had done this for years, right? I worked there for 3 years, and he always ordered this $50 steak and would eat 2/3 of it, maybe 3/4, then bitch and moan, come down, and raise hell to get his money back. And once I got promoted up, I'm like, all right, I'm kind of fucking at it. So he brought it down, and I'm like, not again. Are you kidding me? And I just said, sir, if you don't like the steak, perhaps maybe don't order the steak anymore. I'm not trying to be mean, but I'm just speaking rationally to you, you know? Like, let's not order the steak anymore if you don't like it. Well, I was hoping maybe you get a friggin' chef that cooks that. I'm like, okay, sir, I'm sorry if you don't like our steak, but this is the last time I'm going to refund you for this steak. This is my decision, and I'm going to stand by it. You've done this dozens of times. This is not the first, it's not the third, it's not the fifth time you've done this, and I'm not going to allow it to continue. you know, and that was,
right.
Some
like,
people disagree with what
last.
I did, because, you know, like, it's like, hey, hospitality, but the GM stood by me, and he's like, hey, I got you. I'm like, man, at the end of the day, I'm still here to, you know, keep costs down, this, that, the other, and also, he's exploiting things. And if people are watching that have the same mentality, and they say, oh, he can do that, I can do that all the time. I raise hell,
yep.
Get free food, you know, like, dude, that's not cheap. He's not doing it to get a free club sandwich, he's doing it to get a free $50 steak. You know, like, that
right.
Shit is not cheap.
Yeah, and it's not cool to the restaurants either.
It's not.
Like, 9 times out of 10, you
product,
know the food's
yeah.
fine. And
oh, for sure. And believe me, when something is sent back, like a steak for temperature or whatever, like, that chef is going to baby the next one. If it was, perhaps, a little overcooked or undercooked or whatever.
Right.
But this guy eating, like, if he had brought it down 50 times and it only taken 2 bites out of it, I would have refunded him every time. No questions, nothing. But the fact that he would do that after eating 2/3 of it, I'm like, I'm sorry, man. I can't, in good conscience, continue to let you do this. You know?
Yep.
There's a certain point, and, like, I'm a very nice person, but I'm like, man.
Our damage in this group is better.
It's phenomenal.
Holy
right?
shit.
It is. I love
that was so
this is my first
good.
Experience with the support class. I am loving it, dude. This warlock's
yeah,
like, fuck yeah. Bring
wild.
Loving it, dude. I'm gonna make one. I'm gonna do it.
Yeah, I mean this is so good.
Man, in the late night tonight if you want, when there's nothing, I figure we'll if we time this, let's do like I don't know, maybe one more push in viewer keys or a few viewer keys just to make people happy and then you know, we can I don't know, maybe I'll level that up, or who knows, people might want to watch that. We'll see. I really do need to put points on the board, but it got a little later than I expected. I was hoping to time a couple of keys before this.
Yeah.
It's just like, it doesn't affect me at this point because I'm so seasoned at it, but man, streaming my push keys is not always the best idea. Like, we had that one phenomenal day where, like, I timed 3 22s, then you joined, then we timed 4 or 5 more. You know, that was the best day ever. But not every group and every player can handle that stress. I mean, no kidding. It's I don't just have me, my mom, and my brother watching my stream. I have a good viewership.
Right.
That stresses people out. I mean, it's human
yeah,
nature.
It took
you
me
can't
a
help
day
it.
Or two.
Yeah. I mean, you really can't help it.
But it took me a day or two just playing with you, and it's like, all right, you know. And I would always pull up your stream just to, like, oh, let's see what chat's saying. Because, you know,
yep.
You're just expecting to get roasted, you know?
And I run a pretty tight ship, you know? So, like, I don't really allow that. If somebody says something bad, I would obviously back you up and support you. I mean, that's just kind of who I am, but...
Yeah, well, and that's where I got more comfortable with it. It was just like, okay.
I don't have
chat's
trolls.
Not
I don't
saying
let them
things.
Live. Yeah, nah.
Yeah, and even the guys that were in your chat were, like, supporting, hey, you're a damn good healer, like, whatever.
Yeah, you
they're
got this, you know, like, encouragement. Yeah, I love that. I love it. And that feels good.
That to me
that's
was
what
cool,
we're all about.
And that's when I start- yeah, and that's when I started to feel more confident about it and, like, okay, I'm actually happy to be doing this, you know?
It really is kind of a breath of fresh air when you do have those people who are all kind of cool with everything and supporting you, because you're right. I mean, when I first started streaming, until I kind of would weed out the riffraff or people that didn't fit our mentality and positivity and kind of our way of thinking. I mean, dude, you know, I'll time them out. All right, there's one comment. All right, time them out again. Third one's a ban for just sitting there and ripping on people for no reason. Like, bro, it's not what I'm about. You know, sorry.
Right.
If you don't fit our style, go elsewhere. A lot of other streamers. And that's not me being mean. It's just find your tribe. This is my tribe.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, you're my people. You know, all of my followers are my people. But not everybody's going to like you. Not everybody. Plenty of people don't like me. You know, like, that for whatever
and
reason they want to not like me. You know, like, up to them.
And
that's not my,
and then
that's
it,
not my choice. It's theirs. So.
Yeah, and it's like, okay, that's fine. You don't like me. Great, whatever. Move on.
Exactly.
Don't stay here to talk shit and cause problems.
Yeah.
If you
spend
don't like
spare
me, don't
time
like me.
Sitting here and bashing yeah. me. Like, that is just malicious, and I'm not going to let it continue.
Right.
That's like stepping on somebody's head when they're drowning, you know? Great. Great person.
Right. Yeah, 100%.
One mistake and you rip them. Like, oof. Bust them out this time. Let's go.
See, like there, I was able to get that purge. Otherwise, that's a wipe.
See, he's definitely buffing me, though, too. I mean, he's increasing the damage to everybody. We are fucking pumping, bro. Let's go.
Yeah.
This is awesome.
He's pretty wild.
This will be a good one. I'm recording this for YouTube, so showing the, you know, power of the support class. Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Just gotta keep it up.
Hell, I'm doing 30k DPS as a fucking holy priest.
Hell yeah, dude. I feel like this evens the playing field, too, for, like, classes that aren't as strong, you know? It's like,
yeah,
I like
definitely.
That. Yeah, I like that.
Like, it won't be meta-shifting by any means, right? But it certainly makes it feel a lot better.
Oh, for sure. It'll definitely make the meta more meta in a lot of respects. But, hey, it'll make the non-meta compete, and that's good.
Yep. Now we just need to hope that, you know, people like, Max and stuff don't go off on tier list rants and this
oh
is dog
God.
Shit and whatever. That's one thing that I do respect about Max, though. He's really good about it, of like, hey, this is a tier list, but fucking ignore it. Like, it doesn't matter.
Man, those lists, they do. And, like, I know they're necessary. Anything you do, whether it's college football or a video game, you're gonna have rankings and tier. I get it, you know? But does it get to you? Does it get in your head and mess with you? Absolutely. Best teams in the country lose all the time because they lost focus of keeping their eye on the prize, you know? Keeping that hunger. Because, oh, we're by far the best. Any given Sunday, you can be beat. Hands down.
Well,
just like any key, you know? Like, don't underestimate. Yeah. Don't easy key, blah, 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 GGs. I don't have to interrupt. I don't have to help. Like, dude, you better put your game face on. You can wipe at any key.
The problem that a lot of people have, right, is like you said, it's just that overconfidence. They think they're better than what they're doing and that nothing can impact them. It's just severely not true.
You are right about that. Confidence is great. Overconfidence is a crutch.
Confidence is key. Being a prick is just too far.
You ain't lying.
So we're 5 minutes ahead of our previous run.
I saw that. I know. I'm loving it. We are comfy
right now,
bro.
Dude,
I want
to take this group to another E. Like,
I mean, let's do it, you know? Let's do it. I am loving this. This was a happy accident, wasn't it?
Yeah, 100%, dude. This is wild. And he's helping off-heal, too, so much.
I see that. It all helps, because I've noticed you've been basically full mana the whole run. I'm like, hell yeah,
yep.
That's what I'm talking about. Maybe this is what we need for our push group, though, bro. This is a good learning experience, you know?
Yeah, seriously.
Like, we're great at our classes, but we're both the bottom tank, bottom healer. Maybe we just need a little support. Little something-something.
A little extra love and
hell yeah. I love it, man. I'm all about the teamwork, so seeing the class that helps others, you know, is just pure utility. I love that.
Right, a class that literally only relies on being good at helping other people. Because
I think it influences others to go, huh, you know what, that looks fun. Even though I'm not topping the meters, I can be beneficial in every other way. And that's big to me.
Yeah, it's wild, though. I mean, I'm almost keeping up with the augmentation on damage overall.
That is wild.
And letting him actually off-heal is so nice, too. Ooh.
Oh. Careful.
I'm good.
Glad it's not tyrannical. That jump is deadly. Do need to drink for a sec, do it before we, you know.
I'm okay. All good.
Let's do it. I believe it. I've been watching your mana the whole time, like, dude, it's a different world.
Yeah.
Having some off healing and some kind of buffing. I popped a lot of stuff, but still, he's buffing me. All right. There you go. I'm a DK.
Yeah, seriously.
Making good time though. We can take the gauntlet chill. Nothing, you know, risky. I mean, we're fine. Let's do it. Good feeling to be here 14 minutes. All right,
yeah.
Here we go.
Let's do it.
Trust those icebergs one bit after they're 33.
Yeah, like, not anymore.
Dude, I have never seen that in my life. I just could not believe that iceberg exploded, and then the one behind us exploded and killed four people. Oh boy, okay. That was our. Okay, careful.
Ooh, nope.
After this, yep.
Yep.
Alright. Feet first. I got PTSD after that last one. I keep expecting them to explode and kill everybody.
I know, I keep waiting for it. It's
dude,
scary.
I'm staring at him. I want to see it happen again. I was recording that, so we can actually go back and watch, you know, exactly what did it. Because, man, that was so tragic. We were robbed of that one.
Yeah, I mean, we were close on time, but it really did feel like we got, like, just screwed out
of
the key.
Whether we would have been 2 seconds under or 45 over, we had a shot at it, so.
Yeah.
Which really, if we were super clean on the gauntlet, well, time will keep.
Yeah, definitely.
Careful.
Oh, that's not good.
Yep, move. I'm gonna execute all day. Alright. Gotta go for it sometimes.
Yep. Drinking before we pull.
I know he's thinking the same thing.
Alright, let's do it.
Taking this nice and slow. Man, feels good not being here with 7 minutes left. Let's go.
Thank you.
kill a DPS real fast and keep this size. I'm being careful. Yeah.
Well, these are the guys that keep spawning, though.
They do.
They aren't gonna.
True that. That one, though. That one did the title divergence. I wanted that one down.
Yep.
Sunny?
If we had it, this would be Lust. We're here
right.
too quick.
Oh, for sure. Gotta be careful. Play it safe.
Just the Inundate cast, as long as we get, like, nobody gets one shot to that, we're good.
They're not wrong. My trinket, I knew that was gonna be a little late. I still didn't get that interrupt. All good. Glad I hit it.
This will actually be perfect. My wife's about to be home. I can say hi to her. And
hell yeah. Good timing, brother.
I'm good if you want to just pull the dragon in the boss, by the way. Okay. Like, I have full mana, everything.
Hey,
like,
I'm just being careful. This has been the best halls. I'm like, yeah, we have time. So, like, all right. Plus, Lustle.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess we can just Lust Bowl. So, I was kind of thinking the second we do it, I guess we'll Lust Phase 2. Yeah, we'll Lust Phase 2. All right. Here we go. Time to die, clown. Watch those footsies big time.
I mean, this would be another 23, too, right? So.
Yeah, it will. It's huge. Got another push after.
Yep. And with this group, I feel like we can do it, dude. Like.
We can.
We went slow as shit in the gauntlet. We could have been here 2 or 3 minutes faster, too. And we're just like, nah, we're good. We got time. Like,
you ain't lying.
This is so casual.
Oh, I was big chilling on that gauntlet. You know, because I'm like 11 minutes going into the gauntlet. Hell yeah, I'm going to take my sweet ass time. Yeah, play safe. You ain't lying. We got this in the bag.
Well, what's crazy, too, is like, boss is at 50%. Our warlock without Lust is doing 177k.
Which
like,
means we're easily two phasing this. Yep.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'm just waiting. I'm waiting. He's gonna get through before me. I'm just gonna let him do it. There's too many there. All right. Got like 5 waves on the right side in a row. Woof. Coming. Let's go.
Yeah, seriously. That was so easy. And a 23 Brackenhide. That's not a bad key either.
Dude, that's the key.
I gotta run to the bathroom and try to get a hold of my wife. I will be back.
Okay. Going. We just murdered a 22 Halls of Infusion, the toughest key of the week. Super, super happy.
That's cool.
Yeah. We just saw the new Voker spec, the support class. Oh my gosh.
Oh, the augmentation or whatever
yeah.
It's called.
Dude, I'd never seen it to push keys. So 22 Halls, we made it to the gauntlet with one death and 11 minutes left in a 22. That is completely unheard of. Like, that is astronomically fast. Man, it was a great run.
Yeah. So, the Warlock was doing 181,000 overall. Our Mage was doing 166.
My only regret...
Bama was doing...
I mean, almost 70, right? But I almost wish I ran my DPS trinkets. Because of that, you know? Because I would have done... Shit, I've done 80k with my DPS plus 85k in Brackenhide. I feel like I would have done a lot more with that. Because I didn't know it was going to be that good. Like, that was huge, you know? Like, man, that was... really good.
That's a group you can try to...